What I'd like to do now is I'd like to take it down a little bit more, because a lot of advisors, they've had some of their traditional marketing methods squashed. Some of them need more help actually getting results from their marketing. So I'd like to talk a little bit more about channels and tactics that you're prioritizing right now. So whether it's Jed mentioned a bit ago, the Heroes Act, doing some research on that, that's excellent. We'd love to hear about either subject matter, channels, methods that you're finding to be effective right now for really engaging people in this environment.
Definitely video. I mean, video has just skyrocketed. You know, I feel like I've become a video expert in addition to a Zoom expert in a crash course of, you know, 6 weeks. So we're seeing advisors do a lot of video that they're sending to their clients, and that seems to be resonating really well, in addition to webinars. How about you guys?
Yeah, I'd say webinars. I mean, we're an organization that really relied on face-to-face events. So having to pivot and make them digital has been really interesting. So having live Q&A panels, much like this, where prospects and clients alike can get on and actually ask our panelists questions as it's going on. We've done taped webinars that people can watch on demand. We've had events that are more lifestyle. We've invited our clients to yoga classes and meditation classes that one of our associates puts on every Friday. We've had chefs show how they make their famous fried chicken. So really, we have traditional business development officers that really rely on those face-to-face meetings. And honestly, their paycheck relies on it a little bit too. So figuring out how they can continue to meet with people in a digital era right now has been important. And I think it's something that everybody's probably had to do. And I think the other thing is social media is really big right now and has worked well for us. I think people are on their phones more, they're on social media more because they're at home. We've done more paid social media ads right now, and our results have almost doubled pre-COVID-19. And some are just to get people to sign up for our newsletter. And again, I think that goes back to being hungry for information, right? So it's very low cost and you get great results.
That's excellent. On that point, before we switch gears, I know you mentioned doubling your online advertising results. We've seen that too. Yeah. You mentioned low cost. Can you just quantify? I know advisors are listening, they're saying, what kind of low cost is, yeah, is low cost 20 million? What is
no. No. I mean, we maybe are spending $700 a week, and that's on multiple ads at one time combined, right? So we're not having to spend, and maybe to some advisors that's a huge amount of money, but we're not having to spend a lot to get results. So
And Robert, I would say, you know, again, we've seen the trend in video and webinars happen for some time now. But I would agree with Christa and say, you know, the adoption of virtual or tech-based events and experiences has really, I mean, skyrocketed. And, you know, the ability to, you know, be efficiency but have a high level of return. And an example, and Christina mentioned chefs. We did an event called Cooking for a Cause last month, where we brought Iron Chef Mark Forgione in to, you know, do a cooking class for our advisors, their end clients, families, our resource partners. And, you know, I'll just, you know, let you know, we did the entire experience, you know, for $7,500 all in. And, you know, we reached almost 1,500 people. Right. And for us to think about, you know, doing an event for 1500 people, you know, bringing in an Iron Chef in person, you know, that would have been well over $7,500. And what we are doing now, and Christy said, is we're learning and we're scaling that out to our network. We just had a firm strong box, right, do that in Kansas City, right, and did Cooking for a Cause Kansas City, right, and they're able to extend that at the firm level. So again, with crisis comes this ability to be highly creative, to move faster, to leverage technology, right, to be way more efficient in cost and delivery, But I think most important, you know, to be able to scale, right? Yeah. And say, you know, what works for one, you know, how do we make it relevant and package it, right, for everyone, you know, to be able to leverage.
That's so great. And I love that idea because you could do that with a local restaurant that's popular. You could do it with some of your advisor friends from another side of the country that aren't in competition with you. You could do it together. That's great. Very creative. Judd?
Yeah. I mean, I would echo what most of you guys have said so far. You know, we're seeing a ton of opportunity from paid ads. I'm spending probably an average of about $20,000 a month across all of our offices and a number of participating partners. And that's actually relative to the number of offices. We have 110 offices. So that's like 25% participation. Our cost of acquisition is half of what it was before the crisis. So we're seeing a ton of success from that. We're driving people to really engaging things. It's not just a landing page. It's something they can do, something they can get value for or with. And then secondarily, we're taking webinars and we're making webinars a key part of our marketing, but we're also leveraging evergreen webinars. And things that people can come back to, running ads to those. And they're all completely private labeled to our partners. So they're not a Carson partner brand or our RIA. I mean, if it's Carson Wealth, it's Carson Wealth. But if it's Dynamic Financial Advisors or whatever their name is, like it's completely theirs. And it allows them to be very focused on the opportunity they can create for their prospects. We're helping them with email marketing to do that at scale. Email marketing has still been the most successful of all the different tactics we try. It's still the most successful way to do it. And then I think we're seeing a lot of opportunity just from our advisors that are able to just pick up the phone and say hello. And it's no agenda, just being present for their clients and helping stress the availability that they truly provide to that family is huge. So that's been a big story from this thing. And I think hopefully our advisors are starting to see like, man, I can do so much more than I thought I could. And they'll have a huge ROI for this long term.
That's great insights, Judd. Thank you.
One thing that we've discovered, and I'd be interested, Angel and Robert, if you guys as Snappy Kraken have had this happen as well, but we've always been a huge proponent of in-feed forms, like for Facebook, and in advertising some of our events, we actually created landing pages because we felt like we needed to tell more about the actual event to get people to sign up. And that Q&A panel that I mentioned, it was kind of a spur of the moment event that we decided to do, and we only had 48 hours to advertise it. So the first 24, we had the ad linking to a landing page and we had nobody click, nobody register. So they would click to the landing page, but they wouldn't register. So we pivoted after 24 hours. We had spent $1,000, we put another $1,000 in, and we did an in-feed form, and within 24 hours, we had 100 registrants. So I think a lot of that is because Facebook fills all that out for you, so it makes it much easier. But I also think that goes back to people being on social media on their phone. They don't want to click off. They're stuck at home. They're wanting information. And we typically don't use landing pages that much, but this reinforced that philosophy of, hey, maybe we don't need those. They don't need any more information than what they're getting in that small ad.
Facebook rewards you for having those native ads too. You know, we see that as like, please keep it on our platform. We're going to give you a better number.
We want it to stay.
Surprise, surprise.
Yeah.